The Commission of Inquiry has put a spotlight on some dark places in the QPS.
Sexism, misogyny, bullying, racism and assault running rampant inside the Queensland Police Force.
This has not just happened overnight. This has been happening for quite some time.
The damning report following a three-month probe into police culture and its response to domestic violence that was extended due to an avalanche of evidence.
This police officer walked up behind a female police officer, hugged her from behind and cupped her breast. Another sexual assault. He told another female officer, "You look so hot right now, I'd love to slam you into those cabinets, what I could do to you."
Organisation meant to protect people instead silenced victims.
Officers leaving dog food on colleagues' desks after they made a complaint.
It also enabled abusers. The report made 78 recommendations, including establishing a civilian-led integrity unit so police no longer investigate police.
Let me say very clearly, I expect the reforms to be implemented.
During the inquiry, the Queensland Police Commissioner claimed she too was a victim.
I was pretty well attacked by what I'd say was a sexual predator on my first day of training.
But she's always denied there's widespread sexism and racism in the force.
You knew that there was racism in the QPS.
Yes.
You had been told that a month before, and you stand up and say we're in no way racist. You knew that was not true, Commissioner.
Today, the Queensland Premier throwing her support once again behind the state's top cop, despite the report finding the force has been plagued by a failure in leadership.
To bring about the reforms and the cultural change needs a strong woman, and that strong woman is the Commissioner, Katerina Carroll.
It's very difficult to sit up here and acknowledge and know that our people say and have done terrible things. It's like someone stabs you in the heart because you don't want to hear anymore.
A force in crisis with a long road ahead.
This is an opportunity to do better, and we will.
Richard Monet is a First Nations man who spent 26 years in the Queensland Police Service. He resigned last month and he joins us now. Richard, did any of today's findings surprise you?
Look, thanks for having me on the show. It's not surprising what actually came out from the Commission's of Inquiry's recommendations, and particularly those that actually spoke up. We've heard comments of it being abhorrent. It's appalling. It's absolutely disgusting from what has come out from the Commission of Inquiry today.
So you resigned over sustained racism. The current commissioner has denied widespread racism. Do you think she should still be in the top job?
The issue that I saw over my 26 years was based around systemic issues within the Queensland Police Service, around that lack of cultural awareness and lack of cultural capability up until the day that I actually walked out of the job. So the Commissioner, Katerina Carroll, was aware of the systemic issues, particularly around racism. She was advised about that 2 years earlier, and I walked out because of it. So, you know, in answer to your question, you know, culpability rests at the top. And there should be people accountable for it.
That must be very hard to leave a job that you've committed so much of your life to in circumstances like that.
It's an aspiration. It was an aspiration from a very, very early age. And all I wanted to do was actually apply myself in the best way possible and create those bridges and those gaps in closing for First Nations, Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. But when the system is not working with you but against you, then there are issues.
Richard, a lot of what we heard about today involved the treatment of female police officers, everything from rape to sexual assault, appalling stuff. Did you witness that when you were in the force?
In my earlier days, it was pretty much common for first year constables that were coming out into the workforce, literally to be targeted by field training officers. You know, they basically had their first pick of. The first years that were coming out.
First pick, I'm worried to ask this question. What does that mean?
So the first year constables would come out after graduating from the police academy, and the first year training officers would actually be privy to see who the first year recruits that were coming out to the stations were, so they'd have an opportunity to actually select who they wanted to work with. That's one of the experiences that I've actually seen in my career.
And by that, I presume you mean they selected on grounds that were perhaps not professional?
Yes, correct.
I think I understand what you're saying. Just one thing before I let you go. One of the recommendations of the report is a civilian-led police integrity unit. So this would be the idea that it's civilians investigating police complaints, not police investigating police complaints. How much of a difference do you think that would make?
The organisation in my time has always lacked that element of empathy and that compassionate approach when actually dealing with members internally as well as externally. You know, it's such an institutionalised organisation, and when you have a internal facing organisation which actually supports this level of culture, this toxic culture, there's no avenue for it to actually be more progressive. So an outside external approach would be a way forward. But it's also important that they actually acknowledge that the support that's coming in externally from a civilian should be and should reflect diversity.
Richard, I know it might not be easy for you to address this stuff with us. We appreciate that you've taken the time and found the energy to do so. Thanks so much.
Thank you for having me.